are so many situations when one realizes how women and men react completely differently. Brain dimorphism is a very popular topic in our society and an interesting one to research on different levels. But are we this different because of nurture or nature? Surely a combination of both. In this video, we will look at gender differences at a biological level, as well as linking it to possible explanations in gender type behaviors. Male brains are about 10% larger than female brains and weigh 11 to 12% more than that of a woman. Women are thought to have 10 times more white matter than men. White matter's function is to connect networks in different parts of the brain, making a female more efficient in multitasking skills, for example. Men, on the other hand, have 6.5 times more gray matter than women. It is associated with information processing. Various regions of the brain differ in adult women and men. This is thought to explain certain gender-related behaviors. It is important to note that these are based on correlations. Here are some of them.
The hippocampus is the brain's memory center. It turns short-term memory into long-term ones. This area is larger in women than in men. The amygdala is responsible of the fight-or-flight situation. It is made of two sides. The left side, which pays attention to detail and internal thought, is predominant in women, while for men, it is the right side associated with action and external environment. This area is also larger in men. The prefrontal cortex is where most of the decision-making happens and where emotions are processed. It is larger in women and matures by the early 20s, 2 years before men's. This could explain why women are less likely to have aggressive responses. The parietal cortex, which is responsible for spatial perceptions, is bigger in men. It is thought that is why men have better spatial intelligence. The hypothalamus, where most of the basic functions of life are controlled, including hormonal activity, also shows gender differences. The volume of a specific nucleus in the hypothalamus, which is correlated with sexual drive, is on average twice as large in men as in women. There are still many more differences, and possibly some that haven't been discovered yet, but altogether they cannot be ignored. One question comes to mind. Where do these differences come from? We will look at the chromosomic level, as well as the role of hormones. From conception, there is already one massive difference at the chromosomal level, more precisely on the gender chromosome. It is either XX, which leads to the development of a female, or XY, which leads to a male. The major difference that the male gender chromosome possesses is the SRI gene. The SRI gene is of major importance during the development of a male. Briefly, absence or presence of the SRI gene determines gonadal sex, which via hormonal secretions determine phenotypic sex. In animals, fetal testosterone plays a central role in organizing the brain and in later social behavior. In our case, exposure to atypical levels of prenatal androgens may result in masculine behavior and ability patterns. Normal inter-individual variation in FT levels has also been correlated with later sex type behavior. Actually, it is estradiol that is responsible for the masculinization of the brain. In male fetuses, testosterone is secreted from the testes. It is then converted to estradiol in different parts of the brain by cyclotrone P450 aromatase, which leads to the development of a male brain. While female fetuses are not exposed to testosterone from their gonads, they are still exposed to estradiol from their mothers. To prevent masculinization of the female brain, the female fetus has a protein in its blood that could bind estradiol and prevent it from entering the brain.
In cases where female fetuses had been overexposed to androgen, it was found that these women had more manlike behaviors during their life.
A very recent study has brought yet another difference in brain dimorphism, a difference in connectivity. The study used a technique called diffusion tensor imaging to map neural connections in the brains of 428 males and 521 females aged 8 to 22.
The scans showed greater connectivity between the left and right hemispheres of women's brains. This suggests that women's brains are better wired for social skills and memory, including empathy. On the other hand, the connections in men's brains were mostly confined to individual hemispheres. The only region where men had more connections between the left and right sides of the brain was in the cerebellum, which plays a vital role in motor control. So it would seem that men are hardwired for perception and coordinated actions.
I conducted my own survey to put to the test empathy in both genders. The subjects were shown 9 images portraying emotions by an actress, and they had to choose between 7 possible emotions. Overall, the people who undertook the survey thought that women would succeed. However, when we look at specific gender opinion, men didn't have a distinct one, and some even thought they would succeed. I expected from the start that women would succeed in this task due to my research, which clearly seemed to favor women in this area. Altogether, the test wasn't very well succeeded, so the results weren't very conclusive. However, there is still a slight advantage for women. We'll be right back.